closely related cells that we can identify with our marker schemes, maybe in every single tissue. And they may have slight differences, but they all follow a similar set of rules to get them to regenerate tissues using standard homeostasis processes. One thing that has emerged from the use of these, particularly in clinical settings, there are a number of clinical trials underway for using these, primarily for atrophic response. So these cells are shown to secrete molecules that may promote angiogenesis, for instance. We've been investigating these, but really with the state that things are at right now, we have a difficult time controlling the way they specify and what they turn into, what they differentiate. And so really understanding the microenvironment better, so that we can design better materials for therapy, things like this is important. All right, so I like to make things simple because these systems are incredibly complex, as I think everyone understands from studying biology. So when we talk about signaling in the microenvironment, there's a number of signals that we can consider. Physical signals is one that is important, and as a material scientist, we're interested in exploring some of the physical material properties of individual cells. So these are things like the shape of cells, the shape of tissues, how those arise, and how they're able to manipulate itself that way. The mechanical properties, so stiffness or softness of the matrix, stretch, you know, we're all moving all the time, and our matrices are stretching, and strain is being put on various tissues, and this clearly has an influence on signaling. Chemical cues is my second area that I break things down into, and these include things like small molecules, but more importantly for the purpose of this talk is the precise chemical moieties that you see in the extracellular matrix. So, you know, when you have cells sitting on top of a bed of fibronectin protein, there's a lot going on. It's not just that they're interacting with the protein, they're recognizing very distinct moieties in the ECM. So things like our friend RGD peptide that everybody in biomaterials is aware of. But there's other synergistic ligands and other ones that haven't really been fully explored that have a function. And so we're also interested in exploring what the function of these precise ligands are. And I think there's a lot of room for discovery in this because there's so many integrated ligands on the surface of the cell and so many different ECM proteins. And then the area that's probably been studied the most is biological signaling, as I call it.